So to further add on the first part that I spoke about Dogo Argentinos, game dogs and Petterdales, there are still some good Dogo Argentinos left, and they can also be crossed with other breeds, for example greyhounds to increase speed, pit bulls to increase tenacity and robustness. But you need to be careful with that, because sometimes it's a hit and miss, or you can get heterosis, like hybrid figure in the first generation, and then it can diminish again. But there are also very good game dogs still, but it's quite hard to get them, and also it is hard to give them a purpose in life that really suits them, because they are very powerful, and also there's a big stigma. They don't deserve that stigma, but there is a big stigma in the world. They're also quite a bit bigger than the Petterdale, which is very suitable for taking along as a friendly stigma of just a terrier, which it is in its essence. It has a lot of the benefits of the bigger races. Also very good solid character. It's often a little bit easier around other dogs and less intimidating. It can also be a drawback for those who want a dog that's bad to the bone, and as such also perceived by the public. The bravery of a Petterdale is comparable to the bigger breeds, but they're a little bit different in a way that they sometimes think about what is the best way to attack their quarry. But on the other hand, the biggest one of the three, the Dogo Argentino, I've seen a movie in which a lot of Dogo Argentinos had a lot of trouble catching a hawk and very, very reluctant to really engage. And then they entered one little Petterdale and he just went in and took the hawk. And then the Dogos dared to came to its assistance. But that shows you something. Even this small dog, smaller kind of dog, can have a very big heart, and that's what I really like about them. They're also very very agile. They have strong bones, especially for such a small dog, because you have to have maximum strength in a small package that is able to go down the holes, for example, to engage fox or badger. So they're quite strong in a compact package, and they're also very, very accessible for the public, that they don't have a wrong opinion about them. I mean, let's keep it that way, because they deserve this good opinion. Otherwise, it can be also quite hard to get a good one, but they are working strain, so it's not that hard as compared to, for example, game dog or Dogo Argentino, in my opinion. You just need to have a hunter who allows you access, or hunt together with him. So that were my conclusions on this topic.